Hello, everybody, and welcome again to laranara.com, your leading resource for holistic health in North America. And today we have another great presentation for you. It's an online seminar by Bucher about the Tao medical system. And this is a translation of the original seminar done by Mr. Bucher himself. And we're going to show you everything about the Tao medical, its new features, and how you use it, what it can do for you. It's a wonderful diagnostic system based on ancient Chinese medicine. And at the same time, it's also a regulation system. And we're going to show you all about it, the new features in it, and everything else you need to know. So let's get started. So apart from showing you the general functions of the Tao medical system, today we're going to also focus on two new features that have been included into the system. One, it's called intimate or personal subjects that help you in your diagnosis to focus more on unpleasant or intimate aspects of the patient. And then we're going to look also at another function that's been included. It's called the Lo Shu and He Tu quadrants. Those also are about Chinese numerology and help you a lot in the diagnosis of the patient. So this is going to be a focus, additional focus to the general functioning of the system. The Lo Shu and He Tu quadrants are thereby being calculated based on your birth date and the precise hour of your birth. The Lo Shu and He Tu quadrants give you information about your basic disposition and your disease dispositions that have been genetically imprinted to you at your time of birth and were given to you by your parents. And we're going to integrate these two new features into the general presentation and show you exactly how you can use them, of course. You could call the Tao medical system a Chinese bioresonance system, as it works just like a bioresonance system, but it goes actually far beyond that by implementing millennia-old Chinese wisdom. And for that purpose, the Tao medical system has been packed full with loads of the data from Chinese acupuncture and Yin Qin. It has been co-developed with Dr. Andrea Mercedes Riegel and Hermann Grosser. And together we have implemented the therapy intelligence into the system that can more or less automatically detect the conditions of the patient and enables the therapeut to concentrate on the most important areas of treatment. Before we get started, a short who is who. So Dr. Andrea Mercedes Riegel is a sinologist, so, and is an expert in Chinese language, philosophy, etc. And Hermann Grosser is a specialized in psychobiophysics and a well-known author of many books on this subject. Also, I would like to mention Dr. Jürgen Drews, who helped us to develop and contributed to the questioning technique that helped you diagnose the patient, and he's a holistic practitioner and the head of the Academy of Conscious Medicine. Now I would like to get started with the Tao medical system in action, and here you can see the introduction, startup, or home screen, whatever you want to call it, of the Tao when you just start up the program. And I would like to show you how the software works in detail, based on a case example. So we're going to create a patient and do a scan on the patient. And then we're going to show you also how to balance the patient after we've detected his condition. The system is very easy to use. You see there are three main buttons on the top. And we click here on this one. It's called patients or clients, and you can see the list of all of your patients. You can add them now here, change the data, of course, of the patients, add comments, etc., etc. You just click on this button that adds a patient. It's a human symbol with a plus next to it, and then you get to this screen. On this screen, you can fill all the information in, as we're going to do right now. We're gonna fill in his name. We take a fictitious name, of course, here, Mr. Manfred Musterman, in this case, we're going to select that he's male, his birth date, and his hour of birth, his precise time of birth. Then next to it, you can see that here is a male selection. And so let's presume that this patient feels permanently tired, but still cannot sleep well despite his tiredness. And he feels that he cannot really perform well anymore, like previously, and he gets also a vertigo or dizziness in extreme stress situations. Important to know when you plug in all this information is to notice this field here. It's called the intimate or personal subjects. And this existed previously in the system, but it was mainly used for the color tuning 64. And now we have also activated this function for the Tao Medical software. It works like this. You activate this function when you feel that you can discuss with your patient all subject matter, including unpleasant or private subjects. By actually this function, the patient can see all the positive and the negative findings. If you want to show the patient only the positive findings, or if you think or you know that a patient is very sensitive, we recommend that you first do not activate this function in the first initial scan, as you don't know how the patient is going to react to this touchy subjects. If you know the patients, of course, or you perform the scan on yourself, you have no secrets before yourself, of course, and we recommend in this case that you activate this function to see a full scan, including the negative aspects. In this case scenario, we're going to assume that we don't know the patient yet, that we don't know how sensitive he is, and so we're going to leave this unchecked, this box, just for this example, to show you how the results look without it. And then, of course, afterwards, we're going to also present you with how the negative results look like if this box is activated. On top, you can also see that we have three folders. Apart from the basic information, we have settings and a picture of the patient and the remarks. You can, for example, add a picture like that. We go on the second folder and we click the second button from the left with the open folder symbol to upload a photo from the computer. For this test, of course, we have selected a folder previously already, and here it is. We upload it just like that, and there it is. I get the live questions in our chat, and one of the questions that just came in is if you can import data from the VitaCoach system by Bucher, and it doesn't do it automatically, but yes, you can. You can transfer the whole data set of the patient from one software to the other, no problem at all. So we have now all the data of the patients that we need for performing a scan and finding out what's wrong with the patient. We go back to the main screen here of the patient, to the personal data screen, and now we can directly switch over to the health scan. You can see we have three main buttons on top: the clients, the scan, and the third one, it's called broadcasting / reports. And we go and click on the second button here, that's for scanning. And here you can see the main scan window. Sorry to interrupt, but I get a live question here in the online chat. Somebody's asking if the birth date is being removed when I click intimate subjects, and I'm going to try it out for you here. And in my system, it works pretty well. So now it doesn't erase the birth date. Or the hour of birth or anything. I click here again. No, everything is fine in the system, so must be something else that this customer is having problems with. So let's go back to the scan window, and we have different options here. I can, for example, enter focus for the scan. The default setting is called current situation, and this focus determines on what the scan will focus, what condition. Here in this case, I will enter, for example, that I am extremely fit when it counts, and I can recover very well from a good sleep. We also suffers from depression. Somebody who suffers from depression, I would enter something similar. If somebody suffers, for example, from migraine, I would enter something that focuses on migraine. If it's something undefinable, you just leave this field on its default setting called current condition. Next option we have that we can also select different treatment programs, or multiple one or multiple treatment programs, which will help us detect a problem. For that, you just clicked on the button here called program, and you're gonna see a list of all the programs, but you can also search. In this case, we're gonna type in tiredness, as the patient told us that he feels tired. And you will see immediately that we found a program called anti-aging, which in the description has tiredness, weakness, tired, dried skin, matte hair, and this seems to fit our patients pretty well. So we're gonna select this anti-aging program. Next, the patient also told us about his vertigo or dizziness. So we search here for dizziness, and again, the program here indicated it's called dizziness A. And in the description it says dizziness, vertigo, pale skin, tiredness, lack of energy, palpitations, shallow sleep. This all seems to fit our patient pretty well. So we select that one too, and we take those two programs over. You can see them here indicated. Next, we will select the hardware that we're gonna use for the scan. And here I will take the biosignal tuner with the input cup. And I'm gonna move my camera for you onto the biosignal tuner. Here it is. Now you can insert a DNA sample of the patients into this cup. In this case, we're gonna take a blood drop. And this system is gonna create resonances, and it's gonna check for resonances with the sample. Now I can check if my hardware selection is correct. Here you can see I'm checking it. Yes, it's correct in this case. The input, the biosignal tuner with the input cup is being selected, and now we can start the scan. You see that the input cup lights up whitish while the scan is performed. This input cup, as I said, generates a static field that checks for resonances with the DNA, with the patient's DNA. And here you can see we have already the lower trigram. In this case, it is water or kan, whereby the lower leg is also a changing line. The lower line is a changing line, meaning this can later transform into continuous line based on the other test results. We can see the program has also now detected the upper trigram, called sky in this case, or kian. Together, those two diagrams will result into the final hexagram. In this case, let's see what it is. It's sky, or song. In the foreground, we can also see that the fractal scan is taking place at the same time. It's also been improved, this function, in the new software, so it performs now the scan much quicker. Now you can see the blinking of the input cup, signaling that the scan is complete. And you can see also the picture. We can now close this window and go back into the main menu. And now here on the main screen, as we showed you before, first let's move the camera back to my face. There we go. And we have, of course, these three main buttons, as we showed you before. Clients, we are here now in the client screen, as you can see indicated, then scan that we've just performed. And the third one, it's called reports/broadcasting. We're gonna click on this one, and here you can see a one-line summary of the report. If you perform multiple scans on the patients over time, they're gonna show up in chronological order with the newest one on top. And here you can see just a summary. But if we click on this second button from the left next to the report, we will see a full version of it. So we now can click on the second symbol. And we see here several folders again. Just a second. Let's click on the second symbol from the left. There we go. And then you can see here the report screen. And we have different folders on top. Hexagram, acupuncture, meaning, additional infos. Etc. And we are in the first of the folders called hexagram. There we find also the treatment hexagram on top here, this button that has been suggested by the system. Here it's called diagnosis hexagram 6. In this case, the lines that we mentioned before that can change after the scan, in this case, have stayed the same, resulting in an initial hexagram called dispute or song. And for users, the meaning of the hexagrams and the explanations are not that important, as they are automatically determined by the system. Much more important in this case, it's the so-called Shen formula that we see at the bottom of this screen. And the Shen formula can help the patient gain some guidance for the next week. Here, for example, it says that have a prudent back attitude without fight and have trust in your therapeut. This would be very hands-on advice for the patient that he or she can use immediately to alleviate the problem that he came for. Next, let's go to the acupuncture folder, or the second folder from the left. And here you can see all the acupuncture points. Here you may ask yourself what those numbers next to the acupuncture points mean. They are called the Tao code and are given to each acupuncture point. They signify a frequency that identifies each point clearly for the system, and by that the point can be absolutely precisely determined, and the location on the body as well is saved in the system on an exact location, so the system can develop its full effect even without acupuncture needles. We have also extended the origin of the points. And now we have new PI denominations. This point, for example, this one is an I, and these points with the marked with an I have the origins in the calculation of the I Ching. And these are points that focus on the current condition based on the focus that you've just selected previously for the scan. The points marked with a P come from the treatment programs selected previously. And you also have points marked L, and they come from the Lo Shu and Head To system. And we are going to explain those more in depth later. This one, for example, is a P, and then next we're gonna select an L for you. There you go. This is an L, and this comes from the Lao Shu and Hito system. And as I said, we're gonna go more in depth about this later. You can also select the range of the broadcasting here below. For example, if I only want to see the I Ching, I will only to see only the I Ching acupuncture points, I select only I Ching, as you've seen here, and then I only get the I Ching points displayed. Here you can also see there are some points that have been marked multiple times, and those are especially important to focus on for this patient, of course, they're still gonna be acupuncture, those two, for example. They're gonna be acupunctured only once, of course, but they are for special attention. Now, another thing might be that you choose to add additional points. For example, our patient has dizziness during elevated stress situations, so we can display those points by clicking on the ear symbol that I'm gonna click on. Just give me a second to show you exactly what I mean. So here on the left button of the picture, you have all three symbols, the face, the ear in the middle, and then another body. We click on the ear symbol, as you've seen now, and you can see the ear acupunctural points. And you could, for example, select here 24C, that stands for high blood pressure. Of course, all the points have their explanations, as you can see in the pop-up window. And we can select and add this particular point to the treatment plan. And here we can, with a right click on the mouse, you can select between activate or neutral. It's called add or subtract. Here we're gonna select neutral to activate this point only. And this point is now also added to the list. You can also check points that you've selected and uncheck them here with this first box on the left with this check mark. You can check and uncheck them at your own will, and thereby you can more specify your treatment more. You can also do the same with the whole body acupuncture points. Here the button on the left, you see it, and it zooms you into the body acupuncture points, and you can do just as with the ear acupunctural points, select each one of them and thereby focus more on the points that you deem important for this treatment. You can of course also zoom in and out, and you can also see which program details have been selected here. You see the programs with the symptoms and the therapy target next to them. And then if you want to treat only some selected points, I can click on this middle button and call deactivate all points. And now I can select only the particular points I want. Let's do this. Here I click on the points and select the ones I want only. And then on the left you have a button where you can add all the points again, and then you can just deselect some of the ones you don't want. So very much functionality here and very easy to use as the whole software. All right, so next we're gonna look at the second tab on the top. The third one. And this is called meaning, and there you can see the resonance diagnostics according to Dr. Riegel. Here you can see the psyche, for example, as we have switched off the intimate details in this example. You can only see the positive aspects of the patient's psyche here. Here, for example, it says this type is a strong character with lots of self-confidence. With this confidence, he can deal well with dangerous situations. Neutrality and prudence are his strengths. Giving in or up is not part of his nature, as well as avoiding conflicts. He faces any situations, defends his standpoint, even against opposition, etc., etc. And now, because we've unselected the intimate details, they are not shown, but if we click on the heart symbol right here on the right, as I did just now, you can see the whole description. And in red highlighted, we can see the negative traits, like here he gets too involved into his anger, which causes problems. This creates headaches, for example, neuralgic pain in the lower body area, tinnitus, etc. And when you read something like this to the patient, you could cause a nocebo effect, so a negative placebo effect. Therefore, we recommend not to include this text from the beginning. And that's why you have this function here to cover or uncover it, as this could create negative effects. In most cases, the red text is the opposite side of the text written in black letters. So, for example, if somebody has a strong self-confidence, this could also be seen by others as arrogance. So it's the two sides of the metal that are being shown here. And to show you better what I mean by these examples, what is written in a positive light and what is written in a less positive or more critical light about the patient, I will pull out here an example. It is hexagram number 37. And here it says that this person is creative with a certain willpower. A male wants to achieve something in his work field, and a female wants to be a good mother and housewife who can educate her children well, and surroundings are also should know or are allowed to know about this. And then in red it says the strict, stringent and emotional element on the other side can cause an emotional imbalance, and this can lead to nervous problems. There are showing up in corresponding symptoms like headaches and palpitations, etc. And if the kids do not do as the mother wants, she can become impatient, and this can even lead to a rejection of the whole family, for which she can't feel any love at all in the end. So this is quite a strong statement, of course, the last sentence especially. And if you just would throw this statement at someone like this, she might reject the whole diagnosis or the whole description altogether, because she feels like she needs to defend herself. And of course, she wants to be a good mother, as we've seen in a positive part of the description. And to prevent this, the therapist could, for example, reveal this by asking, so these negative traits, by asking patients instead of stating what the program has found out. And she could ask careful questions like, do you feel unbalanced when kids don't follow your lead? And she could, for example, answer, yeah, you know, sometimes when my son doesn't do his homework, I could just throw him against the wall, you know, sometimes. And this would reflect actually what this evaluation says, but she would get there by herself, and it does not come over as an attack on her. So we recommend that you ask questions and be considerate with your patients, so that they don't reject all the results altogether, just because sometimes it can be a little harsh. So yeah, that's just as a remark. And now let's go back to the meaning screen. You can have more insight here on the bottom left. You can, for example, see three folders or three different tabs. We are here in the psyche tab, but you also have physis and questioning technique. And on physis, if we click on there now, yep, the Eastern resonance pattern appears, and we also have the same functionality with the heart symbol as before. Those remarks here in red are much easier to understand for the patient normally than the psyche diagnosis, but as the patient might interpret this as the real fact and not a description of a possible problem areas for his type, it makes sense here as well not to reveal all this info immediately. And last but not least, we have here a tab called questioning technique. Let's click on it. There we go, questioning technique, and you can see that the default is switched off, But by clicking again on the heart symbol, you can reveal the questions again. Here, for example, what do you want to get off your heart? And here again, be careful with how you ask those questions, how you reveal this information to the patient. And the answers to those questions, together with all the other information, is going to give you a very good insight into the patient and his real or her real condition. Next, let's go to the folder called Fracture. You use it like this. So you show the fractal to the patient and you ask him or her, what does it have to do with you? And that's why it's important also to note or to make notes about and pay very careful attention to the answers that the patient will give you to this and the previous questions in order to make a very, very precise and good diagnosis. All right, now that we are through that, let's go to the next folder called Additional Infos. And here you will find, here we go, Additional Infos. And here you will find remedies like Chinese herbs, homeopathic remedies, and Schüssler salts. Next we have some subfolders here on the left bottom. This info is based on the birth date and time, and it's the head to and low shoe square that we mentioned before. Here you see the two buttons, he too and low shoe. There's an extension program, by the way, the head to and low shoe square that can be purchased additionally. And it's not integrated into the Tao medical system from the beginning. But this expansion would also become activated when you purchase it on all of your other Bucher systems like Color Tuning, Aura Coach, Vita Coach, etc., etc. So it's a very good deal and we highly recommend it. So anyway, let's go to the HITU system. That HITU system is dealing with your birth time. So it's the time during the pregnancy, and I'm going to click on it here. There you go, the HITU square. And here, for example, you see a red square with the number 7 in it. The 7 representing a problem in the 7th month of pregnancy, which then has a effect on the small intestine, as you can see in the small description below. All right, the next tab is of course the low shoe square. This is the evaluation according to your birth date. And then we see here in this example, for example, two red squares. There can be more than two, 6 and 7. And then below we have the explanation. Those correspond to the lungs and the large intestine. Here we can also see on the third row, we can see a little bit. Let's see those. There we go. There you can see the characteristics that correspond to this low shoe square. And how those are being determined is you take the square and you draw lines between the fields in the square. Here, for example, on the very first vertical, 4, 3, 8. And then on the first horizontal, for example, a 4, 9, 2 in this case, and then also a diagonal line that in this case is 2, 5, 8. And these lines are described here in detail below. And by clicking on the heart symbol again, as I'm going to show you just in a second, We can also here reveal also the intimate or less positive traits. Like here, let's click on this and see what it has to say, because this information again is not shown initially if you've not selected it this way. So now we've clicked on the heart symbol, and then we can see here in red, for example, it says often social obligations are being ignored, leading to dissolving friendships, or that friendships never even happen or get started, and often loss and illness jeopardize the health of this type of person. We have on the right the acupuncture points for corrective action. Here you can see them indicated. This also should be revealed to the person in an elegant and considerate manner, of course. Last tab that we're gonna check are the Ling Chen essences. You can see here on the bottom. Just give me a second. Here on the bottom left, we're gonna see the Ling Chen essences. Maybe you see them already. Let's click on them. And the Ling Chen essences. Here we go. Those are determined based on the two trigrams, and those are things that resonate well with the patient. So the last main tab that we have left now on the right is called additional info, and here I can enter, for example, some additional remarks to the scan, like some positive affirmation. I will type in here, I am doing well, exclamation mark. So this is a positive affirmation that could also help the patient. Now that we had a look at all the results, we can start balancing the patient. In this case, we assume the patient is not present, and I would then, for example, imprint a magnetic card with the info and send this card to him. Here you can see such a magnetic card. I'm going to show you one. Let's check. There you go. This is the magnetic card. To imprint it, you just have to plug it into the card encoder of the biosignal tuner, and we will check here in the broadcasting settings shortly if we have selected the right type of devices for the broadcasting. Here they are. We see the biosignal tuner plus the magnetic card. So yep, this is the correct setting. And then we only have to tell the system that we want to have rapid transfer, as the magnet card can be imprinted quickly. And then I just press start broadcasting, and on the screen we're going to see each one of the acupuncture points as it is being imprinted, and the whole process the system goes through, including all the programs, all the affirmations, everything. Here you can see it very nicely. Each acupuncture point as it had been imprinted, the information on the magnetic card. And this takes only a couple of seconds, and we will stay through here and have a look. It's quite nicely done and shown graphically also, I think. There you see left foot, right foot, all the fractal information that's being imprinted as well. Goes through all of the info. You can see it also in the list on the left, how it scrolls through all their points. Very neat system. And now the scan is complete. It shows you here, imprinting is complete. And we just click OK. We can extract the magnetic card, and we could send this now to our patient. We recommend that a patient then wears this card on him all the time to get his positive resonance into his body in order to heal himself, of course. And now let's go back to the main page, and I want to show you the report printout and how this is being performed. Here we go, main page. You see here the report again, and the first button on the left is being selected by with the magnifying glass on it. Here you see that you can select between some options. Yep, here you have the options. If this report is, for example, for the patient or the therapeut, and we're going to select here patient report. And then you're going to see plug. We click OK. And then we're going to see patient report. Yep, everything is selected correctly. And as we have not selected the intimate information, it's not going to show up in this report. If we have selected it, it is going to be included in the report. But with all the information we went through in detail before, as you can see, all of it piece by piece, as we've discussed. Here the psyche description again, according to Dr. Regel, the physis description. Here you have the fractal graph. All of the information that we've mentioned, the Lao Shu square. Birth date, birth time. Just everything as described before. Here the whole description of the character traits according to the lines. And the last one, the affirmation that I typed in, I'm doing very well. And then I want you to show you also the version of the same report. We go back and click again on the magnifying glass for a printout. And now I'm going to select therapeut report to show you the difference. And the main difference is that we now have the complete text, including the less positive intimate aspects, as you will see here in red, just as we saw them before in the program. There you see. And in blue, you have a remark about what we've already mentioned in the presentation, that you should deliver this information to your patient carefully. It states it here again on the report. And then in red, you have the more delicate information. So this is more or less it. The patient, of course, by wearing the magnetic card on himself, can permanently receive the imprinted healing frequencies that are, in this case, tailor-made just for his or her condition. And the scans can be updated periodically, and of course we check from time to time how the patient is doing, have there been improvements. He doesn't need to send a sample in, a new sample every time, as once we've recorded his or her information, everything else can be updated periodically, you know, all the scans, and we can imprint new cards for him or her, and it's a very, very neat system to use. Let's check in our online chat if anybody has a further question. And or if you need any clarification, anybody, on any of the information displayed to you. I think it was pretty comprehensive, so I assume there will be not many questions, and I cannot see any so far. But I would also like to show you some other functions of the system which are really useful, and for that let's go again on the report function. Yeah, here all that report again, the printout version, but I want to go back to the summary version of the report, as there are no further questions as I see. Alright, and I'm gonna show you a very neat feature that it's called the import and export feature. And it's very easy to use and activate. So let's go through it. We go here on client, no, on the report I mean. And the second button from the right is to be clicked. So let's click on this button. And you're gonna see two options. Import all the data set, including information or export. We're gonna select here the export function. They're gonna have a pop-up window asking you, yeah, you want to export this data? Of course we want, yes. And then it's gonna ask you for the place to put this data into, and you're gonna have this Window Explorer window pop up. And here, of course, you can save it under the name that you've selected for it. And you can now share these test results with another fellow therapist or human being that also owns the Tao medical system. You could also take it with you and or share it with another computer that is yours. Very handy when, for example, you're on a trip and you want to upload another info or something like this. So very useful and easy to use function. Here the export function. Now I also would like to show you the import function, and for that I have created a test report yesterday and I have sent it to this computer in the same format that you've seen here in the zip format. And now I want to integrate it into my patient file that I have here for this patient. So let's show how this is done. We go into client page again, and you have a very similar symbol here on the right second from the right. And this is the upload or import button. You click it, you go through your data, you're gonna find a folder and everything where you have selected to store this information. And then you just select the report, here it is, that I've sent to myself in this case. It gives you all the data about the report, client, etc., etc. And then we check if everything is okay, and we're gonna click OK. And we can import it. You even get the photo of the patient in question. And now we can just click OK. And we're gonna get all the data from this new report into our system so that we can synchronize the systems with each other. Here we go. Okay. Of course, the system asks me here if it's an existing patient or not. In this case, I'm gonna select that it's a non-existing patient. There we go. And okay. Import, and then we see the new data set has been created in my system very quickly. Doesn't takes no time at all. And here we see our new patient, and then we can go into reports and see all the report data in detail as before. There we go, with the fractal picture. Of course it's a female, so this time with a female body. Fractal, all the data just as before. No loss of data, all the information is being transferred in with this function. So very useful to keep all of your computers synchronized or share information with your fellow therapist, etc. Another thing that I would like to show you, last but not least, is how we have changed the fractal function. It used to take a very long time to generate a fractal picture, and now we have updated the system and it takes much less. And I'm going to show you how you can select the size of the fractal picture. If your system still takes too long, I think there's a very neat new feature that we've integrated in this. So this is what I would like to share with you right now. And here we can, wait a second, we can go to settings for the fractal. There we are, settings. Then we see all the settings. You have a lot of stuff here that you can play with, but we want to go to the fractal size, Tao Medical, of course. And here you see that you can change the size of the fractal picture according to your needs. Very neat new feature that has been integrated in the newest software version here. So thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you got a really good insight into this wonderful, easy to use and very effective diagnostics and healing system or balancing system, whatever you want to call it. It's based on thousands of years of knowledge from the Chinese, coupled with modern technology and bioresonance. And in this case, if there are no further questions in the chat, I would like to thank you all again, and hope to see you soon again here at lyranara.com, your leading healing resource for holistic health in North America. Thank you very much. Here and see you from you again. Bye.